Some people go their whole lives without ever writing a single poem. Extraordinary people who don't hesitate to cut somebody's heart or skull open. They go to baseball games with the greatest of ease and play a few rounds of golf as if it were nothing. These same people stroll into a church as if that were a natural part of life. Investing money is second nature to them. They contribute to political campaigns that have absolutely no poetry in them and promise none for the future. They sit around the dinner table at night and pretend as though nothing is missing. Their children get caught shoplifting at the mall, and no one admits that it is poetry they are missing. The family dog howls all night, lonely and starving for more poetry in his life. Why is it so difficult for them to see that without poetry, their lives are effluvial? Sure, they have their banquets, their celebrations, croquet fox hunts, their seashores and sunsets, their cocktails on the balcony, dog races and all that kissing and hugging, and don't forget the good deeds, the charity work, nursing the baby squirrels all through the night, filling the bird feeders all winter, helping the stranger change her tire. Still, there is that disagreeable exhalation from decaying matter, subtle but ever-present. They walk around erect like champions. They are smooth-spoken and witty. When alone, rare occasion, they stare into the mirror for hours, bewildered. There was something they meant to say but didn't. And if we put the statue of the rhinoceros next to the tweezers and walk around the room three times, learn to yodel, shave our heads, call our ancestors back from the dead? Poetry, why is it still a bust, bankrupt? You haven't scribbled a syllable of it yet. You're a nowhere man, misfiring the very essence of your life. Flustering, nothing from nothing, and back again. The hereafter may not last all that long. Radiant childhood, sweetheart, secret code of everlasting joy and sorrow. Fanciful pinstrokes beneath the eyelids. All day, all night meditation, knot of hope. Kernel of desire, pure ordinariness of life, seeking through poetry a benediction or a bed to lie down on to connect, reveal, explore, or to imbue meaning on the day's extravagant labor. And yet it's cruel to expect too much. It's a rare species of bird that refuses to be categorized. Its song is barely audible. It is like a dragonfly in a dream. Here, then there, then here again. Low flying, amber wing darting upward, then out of sight. And the dream has a pain in its heart, the wonders of which are manifold. Or so the story is told. Dream On, a poem by James Tate.